Hi, I'm Caitlin, and this is Battle Sounds with Kate. Today, we're gonna watch Pepper fly. First, I'm gonna tell you the supplies you won't need. A bowl filled with water. It can be cold or hot. Dish soap. And a little tiny bit of pepper. Tiny. For safety, goggles.
I'm not doing that a third time.
First, take your pepper, pour a little bit of it into the bowl, carefully stir. Dip your finger in. Nothing happened, right? Then, wash your finger off. Now, you are going to dip your finger in the dish soap. Very lightly, put it down. Cool. Boom! So the science of it is that it's like water molecules like to hold on to each other and stay close. And when they're doing that, whatever they're holding on to will stay. But when something comes through that they don't like, or that is too, it's kind of like that's too heavy, and they break, it falls through. Like, let's pretend that water molecules hate pickles. And then a pickle comes. It drops. Just like that. My dad. No. He's weird. Awesome. Yeah, so go be awesome. No. Now I'm going to share a Bible verse with you. 1 John 4:18a. There is no fear in love. Instead, perfect love drives away fear. The Bible lesson of it is, it's kind of like the water is us, the salt is fear, and the pepper is fear, and the dish soap is God's love. When fear comes to us, and we're scared, and all those things happen, and then God's love comes, it floats away, and then we're... Fearless, I'm holding back. Fearless, because I believe you're with me now. Bring on the unknown, leave me and I'll go. You set me free, God, I wanna be. Fearless, I want to be. Fearless, I want to be. These giants. And then, and next, we're gonna do another one in this same video. What? For this experiment, you'll need a jar of water, a waterproof card, and keep away a mess. A pan. Carefully put your right hand on the card and put the card on the drawer. Push down, not so hard, but a little hard. Very carefully flip it over. Push down. And then lift your hand up. Ta-da! The science of it is that the air pressure on the inside of the jar is less than the air pressure on the outside of the jar, which makes the card stay in place. The Bible lesson of it is that sometimes when we're about to do something like what I just did, we think, oh no, it's gonna make a huge mess. Like in life choices, when we're doing something and we know that God is telling us to do it, like in Jonah and the big fish, he knows that God was telling him, Jonah knows that God was telling him to go to Nineveh and tell the people, the bad people who can really hurt them. And he thought, oh no, that's gonna make a huge mess, I'm gonna get hurt. So he ran off. But in the end, he saw that God had a good choice and he made a good choice. And none of that happened, none of the big fish part would have happened if he just trusted God and went to Nineveh. And the Bible lesson is, we just have to trust God and just go with whatever he tells us to go with. And now I'm gonna share a Bible verse with you. Proverbs 3:5, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Thank you for watching Bible Science with Kay. Please like and subscribe to my channel. The way that you got this, give me the faith that you got this even today. You got this. I know that I know that I know that you got this. Please subscribe and like my channel.
So we chose these two experiments this week because we know that there's a lot of fear out there right now with
because
of the coronavirus. And we understand why that can be a fearful thing, and we know that it's serious, but we want to make sure that everyone is comforted to know that God is still in control.
And he has everything under control.
And we're going to trust him. And we still want to use our brains and wash our hands.
And think wisely about how you're going to do things and what you're going to touch on your body. And
right. Try not to touch our faces.
Like, if you think, I really need to touch my eye for some reason, think why you should touch your eye. If it's an itch, you can just...
Or maybe wash your hands first before you have to itch
your eye. Or just don't... If you don't want to wash your hands before you do it, just don't itch your eye.
So we just wanted to take this opportunity to remind everyone what Paul told Timothy, that we're not given the spirit of fear, but of love. And so
we're given the spirit of fear, we're given the power of love.
That's right.
I want to be fearless.
So we want to make sure to continue treating others with love and kindness and
stay healthy.
And just trust the Lord with this. And we'll be praying for our country. And wash your hands.
Please.
We already said that.
My dad is really weird.
Wash your hands.
But yes, please wash your hands. And don't touch your eyes, your mouth, your nose. Because those are open places for germs to get in your body.
This is
and
true.
When you sneeze, don't sneeze in your hand. Because let's pretend that I just sneezed, achoo, in my hand. And then I shake my mom's hand.
I'm not doing it. We're gonna
pretend. And then I just shake my mom's hand. Oh no, I gave her germs.
They're on me now.
So sneeze, achoo, in your elbow. And if you wanna greet someone, do not shake your hands. Do not high five. But the cleanest one is a fist bump.
Yeah, or really even just like a wave from a distance.
Yeah, because that's
too.
Really good.
Yeah,
don't over exaggerate and go wah and just go really, really far. Bye.
Bye.
Wash your hands.